Hello everyone, Cesare here with more Final Fantasy 14 today. We have the joy of starting us off right here in Aleport. Unfortunately, I
Hello
was
everyone,
held.
Cesare here
Hang
with
on.
more Final Fantasy 14.
There we go. I had to double my voice there. Anyway, I was gonna show off Aleport a bit, but I cannot because it is now nighttime. And as you can see, you can't see a lot at nighttime. But I'll look out over the landscape, and you can kind of see that. But the glare of the aetherite does not let me do it. Anyway, on call with me today we have Juba Dingles. He's gonna be joining us and doing some voices today. Say hello, Juba.
Hello.
We have Silly Lissandra.
What?
Or Mini Mira.
That's not me.
And we have Wintrig or Piamet or one of the other myriad of names that we know her by.
Pac-a-Mat.
Pac-a-Mat, yes, which is what I call her.
Hello.
Anyway, and also joining us is the wonderful Miro. Oops.
I was like, oh my God, there's someone else here.
Miro, she gives us a wave. All right. So what we're gonna do today is we're gonna start off right where we left off last week in, well, Aleport, obviously, because that's where we are. But we're just outside the quest called "It's Probably Pirates." And Piamet really wanted to voice a character, but unfortunately could not make it last week, and almost missed this week. Not literally, but you get the idea. All right. So, from here, I'm gonna head up to the quest turn-in. As you can see, we're gonna look around at the. Hey, look, there's a level 50. I should fight it. It's a helmet crab. It's quite literally a helmet crab, in that it's a crab wearing a helmet. Look at that. If I fight it, it will kill me, though. Anyway, there shouldn't be too much I need to do a bunch of side quests. It should be a lot of main quests and just random things I decide to do over the next few weeks. But the first thing here is the yellow jacket, which I think I will do the voice for. Hang on, is that a man or a woman? That's a man. But please tell me you're here on yellow jacket duty and not some deaf sod out for a stroll. I can't take any more of this blasted waiting. You are? Oh, thank the gods. I assume you already know about the ship that been slipping around the Isles of Umbra. We've been on the lookout for pirate activity ever since the vessel was sighted, thinking a crew of cutthroats might have a den nearby. So when we received word that men of questionable quality had been seen passing in and out of Sastasha here, we weren't entirely surprised. I've yet to see them for myself, but if this lot belongs to those fishback fancying serpent reavers, well, you can imagine the panic it'll cause. The kidnappings are still fresh in people's minds. Anyway, your task is to poke around in the caves and find out exactly who you're dealing with. While you do that, I'll be keeping watch out here, praying you don't spot any blue face tattoos. Use the duty finder to enter Sastasha. All right. So, if you see right here, is a group of adventurers. So, Piamet is gonna voice Etta. She's gonna voice Liavine. Juba can voice Peoreo, and Silly can voice Avir. All right, so everyone, can you see my screen?
Yeah.
Yes.
All right, is it clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Excellent.
Semi-clear.
I'm going to talk to Avir first, Silly.
What took you so bloody long, Edda? If me purse was too light, you might have considered using some of your own bleeding coin to get us what we need. You've only ever been as useful as the contents of your pockets. The gods know you can barely heal a scratch. We took up the venture in life to take out big jobs and claim the big rewards. How are we meant to do that if you can't even get our supplies in order? It's the one better one was talking to. Well, we'll see who gets the glory. This job should have been ours in the first place.
Now for Etta.
I'm sorry, Avir. I came as fast as I could. I tried haggling with the merchant, but two potions was the best I could get with the money you gave me. I had no idea how expensive they were.
All right, Peoreo, Juba.
This is perfect for our inaugural outing as a party. Wandering around in the caves, turning over a few rocks, how difficult could it possibly be? I never expected our first visit to the Adventurers Guild would yield such a straightforward way to win fame and fortune.
And Livian.
Edda, you're so slow. You'd lose a foot race to a tree slug.
Alright, so there's a reason I did those characters there, and because they will be showing up later. So we are going to invite Juba, Silly, and Piamet, because we are now going to do our first dungeon!
The Double Pugilist Dream.
So, Silly's going to tank for us, I think, unless Piamet wants to tank.
Piamet did not want to tank.
Alright, Piamet, are you in the role that you did want to play?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to cue us into Sastasha now. To do that, we just open our duty finder. Now this one, the Realm Reborn tab, is open. We're going to Sastasha. Oh, hang on, I gotta clear my selection. There we go. And join.
Cue for Sastasha or Guildhest Roulette. Just get Guildhest Roulette. Wait a minute, this isn't Sastasha.
At level 20, we will be doing another Guildhest, though. Because a new one opens up. Alright, so as I said, this is the opening to Sastasha. Silly PM, make sure your cutscenes are turned on.
I turned it on, but it didn't work. Hold on.
Make sure you hit apply after.
Oh, thanks for the reminder. Though, is there anything I have to voice?
I don't think so, except for the bird.
Now I have to find the...
Is the bird in the cutscene?
It might be. Okay, so the thing is, Juba, as I said, for the first fight with the guy you're voicing, you have to pay attention to your chat or just bubbles that pop up on the screen or over his head, okay?
Okay.
So when we're doing the fight, everyone, you gotta be quiet during boss fights. Just no idle chit-chat for that. I'm turning up my volume now. Okay, here we go. Silly's ready to lead us in. This is the first dungeon, the Sastasha Seagrot. As you can see, it's very bright, very pretty dungeon, even at the start. It's a good way to get you started into dungeons in Final Fantasy XIV. So the objective is primarily just to beat up the enemies until we get to each boss. Oh, Juba, you have to get the note on the floor up ahead as well.
Alright.
I think.
Yeah. Unless we want to guess.
Well, no, I don't.
If you get it wrong.
I don't know the color.
If we guess, it'll give the real genuine dungeon finder effect. Unless we guess right.
But as far as story goes, I want to have it, so hang on, let me go check it. I'll check it and see if it's something that Juba should be reading or not.
I think it's one of his henchmen that says it.
Yeah. You find a bloodstained scrap of parchment with a message scrawled upon it in faded ink. The captain likes his cabbage green! Alright, so that's what it says. The captain likes his cabbage green. It's spelled very badly.
Hey, maybe that's just how they spell in pirate.
We gotta think they are pirates. They probably don't have that great of an education.
It's true. Well, they have enough education to know how to form words.
Barely.
The semblance of a word. These black bats messing with me.
I like how one of the dark enemies is just kick person in the chest.
Oh, hang on. Before we go on, Piamet, how did you adjust the name tags?
Oh,
display name settings?
How do you want to adjust them? I think it's in character configuration, display name settings, and then you have a bunch of tabs at the top on others, NPCs. Of course, I didn't change my own at all, because I'm important.
Oh, that's on my own. Okay, hang on.
Yeah. So other PCs would be other players. I have it set to only show them when they're fighting something. Friends, always. Alliance members, when they're fighting. Party members, always.
Okay, so it's not going to show your names, guys, unless I target you, and it's just going to be your initials.
Wow. We feel appreciated.
That EOS is owned by Peanut Butter.
All right. Let's go. Good. This way there's no clutter. People can see things a little better. I keep forgetting to put twin snakes up.
Nice. Oh, no. I should give us the full dungeon experience by standing in paralyzing tendrils.
Should also give us the full dungeon experience by pulling everything.
I don't have leeches.
Oh, wait. What class are you playing? Why don't you have dispel?
I'm playing Eos.
You're playing Eos.
Eos spec.
See, unlike you, I don't care what you play.
Hey.
No, it's because I just woke up.
You're worried about me dying to
Yes. I need Eos.
Oh my god. Eos could solo heal this dungeon without you lifting a finger.
That sounds like a challenge, but I'm not going to take you up on Miro's stream.
I dare you to let me tank the boss without you healing me one time.
Do that later.
I'll just use cooldown.
I know you'd be fine, but that's only because it's the first dungeon.
Well, yeah, we get to walk around on coral now. Or whatever the hell this is supposed to be.
I think it's, melted, Skittles.
Not melted Skittles. Just floating on the water there. Solidified enough to form a path that we can walk on.
Oh, silly. I don't think tank-specific rings really exist at this level.
There's gotta be, like, vitality rings. I just kicked it when it was in here.
Well, you've got the brand new ring.
Oh, I could get that. That's true. I haven't gotten it on this character yet, so...
Oh, yeah, right. You're a Dark Knight.
Oh, that's true. I have mustard eggs. I'm eating those.
I thought you meant for level 15. Oh my god, this is why I brought Eos.
Siphon Strike is a good attack.
Make sure you use Blood Weapon a lot.
I will. I use it when there are more mobs or on a boss.
There we go. Miro levels up.
It only has like a 40 second cooldown or something, right?
Miro leveled up. Good job, Miro.
Just level 20.
On it.
Which means after this, before we do anything else, we are going to go do our job quest. Oh, okay.
The dungeon experience. I accidentally tabbed to a fossil shell.
It's okay.
I don't know why. I don't believe in healer DPS.
Oh, we're going to have to boot you from the FC.
No!
Boot the guildmaster out.
Oh, by the way, I put the guild's birthday on my calendar, so... Yeah. Because I'm a loser.
Off
of that. Well, I'm sure we'll do something in celebration. Because it's coming up in a couple months.
The birthday, yeah, but the only people who can celebrate are you, me, and Miro.
Just wow. That's...
Way to just exclude everyone.
Well, we were the only people who were here.
Screw you guys.
We pull everything, Miro.
We pulled this shit together.
I want to show off the entire dungeon while we're here, so...
I think that Sastasha, especially for her first dungeon, was... It's very cool looking. You know, I remember the first time I came in here and I was like, this is, like, very different from starting in Ragefire Chasm. Not to compare it to other games, but starting in, like, Ragefire Chasm or Stormwind. stockades and things like that, even the first rift dungeons and stuff like that.
Juba stole Miro's treasure.
Oh, no.
Well, to be fair, I still got the treasure.
Bottles of secret water.
But
I don't know what that's for.
Probably crafting. Yeah, crafting material.
Yeah.
Silly, to be fair, Stockades was not a beginning dungeon.
Right, I mean it was like
funny or something.
Oh, I actually like the recreation of Stockades.
Yeah, but it was still Stockades.
So to anyone here that hasn't played this game, these giant clams, they create these Shade Seekers when they open up. And when they open, and when when they close, you can't damage them. What are you owing?
Oh my god, I never knew that.
Aw, so it was green, right?
Yes, so up here, we got a kind of puzzle that we have to do. And remember, the captain likes his cabbage green, so we click the green coral formation.
And everybody look out from where the boss
and that causes
stands.
An inconspicuous switch to form. Well, there is our first boss, Chopper. Oh, I'm so out of touch with playing my monk, I keep forgetting to put Twin Snakes up.
Oh my gosh.
I keep forgetting to hit my positionals.
Oh, well, at least I don't do that. At least I hit those. So for Charged Whisker, we just run out of it or Silly stuns it.
I didn't stun the first one because I wanted to get a good threat lead. I used my stun.
Yeah.
But you can only really stun every other one anyway.
Yeah. The reason you want to stun it, because if you don't, you take a little bit of damage and you get paralyzed. More annoying than anything. Alright, so our first treasure, we get Plundered Trousers. Nothing I can use, but I'm probably going to win them if we all roll greed.
I'm not going to greed on anything in here.
Hey, you can sell those. Why wouldn't you agree on those?
I don't care. And plus, then you can have it. On
you can disenchant. What's the word? Desynthesize them and level up your decent. But my decent is too high on some things.
All right, Juba, your time to shine is coming up.
PMS too.
No, why are you making me?
Oh yeah, the bird does talk.
It's gonna be so hard.
Alright. Silly, you can be the bird.
I'll try to be the bird, yeah.
Because Piamet's healing, she doesn't have to be up in range of it, whereas you do.
Yeah, I might miss things.
So people
spend the whole time running away from the bird?
So people can hear Juba, make sure you wait until he's done his line.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, here he goes.
Don't give the bird an offensive voice.
How did you find this place?
Squawk! Like, what am I supposed to do if I can't give it an offensive voice?
Squawk!
No, not during boss fights.
Loyal pups.
Batten down the hatches! Batten down the hatches! Squawk!
Where are me men? Where are me mates? Try and catch me, you two-legged lubber.
Two-legged lubber! Two-legged lubber! Squawk!
Hey, cool weapon for Mira.
Is gonna steal it from you.
I am not, because that is a minus one on me.
Oh.
I rolled a 3. Excellent.
Hey, you still got it.
There you go.
Alright, Silly, so we're gonna go through this room clockwise. Oh, we're gonna kill everything in the room, and then we're gonna go to the side rooms.
Oh, okay, so you wanna go through this room and then go to the side rooms?
Yeah, so we're gonna kill everything in the big center room and then to the side rooms.
Okay.
Ah, I'm stuck. There we go.
Oh no.
feel like Monk becomes a little more exciting quicker than other melee jobs because we get more than one attack we can use.
Yeah.
But it ends, yeah, like Dragoon. Whereas, and even if it's not that great, because we get an entire, like, mini rotation to do, whereas nobody else does.
Yeah, I mean, you could use more than one ability, more than one main attack ability on Dragoon, but it. There's no reason to do that.
Literally the same damage.
Or better, it might even be better 170 times 2 over.
The Shallow Skill Reaver drops a Captain Quarters key. That'll be important for getting through the dungeon, but we're not going there right away. First, we're gonna go to the right here.
Oh, going right, not going left first.
No,
oh,
we'll circle
for you,
then.
It's. Oh, I see. So we're going over here.
You said clockwise.
I was looking at clockwise.
Actually, I have no idea where.
I don't think I've been in this room in a really long time.
I've never been in these rooms.
Get them grumpers off me, Grog! Silly, say that one.
Sod off, I drink what I want!
I'll cut your gobs! To the abyss with you! They're actually fighting, it's great. Not before I catch you a new pistol! Lovely.
I think that guy heals. Oh wait, maybe they all heal, I don't know. Sorry. Doesn't really matter, I guess.
Someone's healing.
It is the one that you marked.
Oh, I just figured. Since they're all called Shallow Scale Reaver, maybe they all have the ability to do so. Yeah, it seems like they all have some sort of capacity to.
It seems like it's second window mod.
Yeah.
I put Miasma up on them.
Excellent. For the healing reduction.
Yeah. Thinking hard.
I approve.
Thinking smart.
Thinking Mira. Alright, treasure.
That's not doing what I do. Bane Miasma 2 by itself.
Nice. I've done that.
See, we could have left those enemies to just sit there and fight each other, but, you know, whatever. We'll get involved in their little barroom brawl.
Yeah. Ballroom blitz.
Alright, so here's two dudes just hanging out. The hole. Oh, Payman, I think there's people in here that you can voice.
Wow. That's sexist.
They look like women on the other side of the bars.
Just because it's the hole.
You said it.
Forgive me, my lord. I did not mean to offend. Slit them between the legs. Every last one of them. Yeah. Mother, father, what did I do to deserve this? Oh,
sad. What are these ones saying?
Oh, there's more. Am I free?
Don't seem to say anything else.
That's it.
She's the only Lalafell that still has a tongue.
Disgusting.
But like all Lalafells, they don't have a soul.
That is true.
Alright, so we're gonna go up into the captain's quarters. Silly, you can voice the captain. Well, not the captain, but the dude who's in there.
Okay. There's ladies. Two.
Yeah, this corner is a Shallow Tail Weaver.
I'm not one of them. I swear upon what little remains of my dignity. I think she said something like that. I picked it really fast.
Yeah. It's okay if you can't get it on. Oh, virtue.
Who are you? Oh, she keeps saying it. What is it?
That nerd didn't say anything.
Oh, I thought he did.
Alright, there we go. I got to see what he said.
Alright, so we're not going to go through that door yet, silly, but we're going to go kill the guys in front of it.
Okay. I want to kill them first, okay.
So we got the key to this gate by going into the captain's quarters.
It's nice to have two DPS who know to focus on the same target, because then I can, like, hit that target a couple times, and I know by the time it dies, neither one of them will have threat on it.
Okay, so now we're gonna go up here, and I think there's another lady up here, Payment.
The lady or the tiger?
Indeed.
Oh.
Alright, she didn't say anything. Alright, what's up in this way?
Oh, jumping fences.
Oh, silly pulled some things, so let's kill those.
I just wanted to play against me on a different team than me. What the hell is this guy doing? He's like, I found the sniping spot, everyone. What an asshole.
Rude.
I have a bow. And I don't have to get close.
See, if you use blood weapon, it increases your damage and speed and gives you MP, and then you can use Unleash more, and also do more damages.
Thank you for the information.
Blood Weapon is so good.
That's good. I use it pretty
That's well. The only upside of not having crit yet.
Now we're in the Navigator's Corridor. Or Quarters.
Forgot that existed. I'm here!
Not all dungeons in the game have like these off-side rooms or anything, so that's why I'm kind of just showing them off here.
The problem is I don't really unleash that much. I mean, I do, a little bit.
That's kind of changing.
I unleash once per mob in the group.
I unleash as many times as I feel like it, which is usually somewhere between 0 and 60.
Somewhere between 0 and 60.
You should use it as much as you would use Flash, yeah, like Miro said.
Yeah, I know. This is not my first rodeo.
Alright.
Or something. I don't know. Or...
Kill the archer first.
Yeah. Wow, he was stunned for an extremely long time compared to what I thought he would be stunned for.
There you go.
Do you like how he's up on that barrel?
He's an asshole.
He's gonna do a barrel roll.
He's flashing his underwear at my face by his doing subligar. Kicks.
This must be where they keep the grog. Ah, oh, subligars. Can fuck off. Alright, and there's one more room.
Yeah.
I really hope Miro has to wear a subligar at some point.
No, he did, but he didn't wear it.
I gotta
see. No, he, like, didn't take it.
He just didn't upgrade his gear. No, he took the gear, but he never wore it. That was the best thing about it. It was like, oh, Sulfagar, I'll just have to suffer with a lower level of gear until I get a new one.
Miro will not be subject to Sulfagars. Worst piece of equipment ever.
There's some cute ones.
What? There's no cute Sulfagar.
Yeah, there are.
There's ugly, and then there's, like, poop brown color.
And we're the ones that are, like, cougar... You know, patterned things or.
Ew!
No, you mean the one the Rogadins wear?
Rogadins? Yeah.
Alright, so okay, now.
Maybe
we'll
they're only cute it. On me.
You pretty much think only the things that you wear are cute. You don't think they're cute on anyone else.
It's true, though.
I was asking Piamet to help me make a glamour, and she's like. I was like, do you think this would look good on me? And she's like, no, nothing would look good on you, but it would look good on me.
I'm this like, locked door.
I don't think we can go in there. That'd be cool if we could, though.
All right, so beware of this. We're going to be moving the boss, so...
Yeah, I'm going to move him immediately, just because that's what I usually do.
All right, just so they make sure you're in earshot of the bird.
Mm-hmm. Squaw.
Back for more, eh? I sharpened my blade just for the occasion.
Scurvy dog! Scurvy dog! Squawk!
Eat him alive. What do you see now? Nothing. Nothing at all.
Captain is strong. Captain is strong. Squawk!
Might you consider a parlay?
Parlay, 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 squawk! You know, I wonder if you can stun him at like 21% and then get him down lower, but I think he'll just run away anyway.
I think so, yeah.
He'll just break it, you know? I never tried it.
Pretty sure he does. Go for the archer in the back first.
Oh.
Who's gonna go for Bayonet?
That one just would. He was in my unleash, but it didn't actually hit him. And I was like, oh, okay.
Yeah.
That's nice of you to.
Welcome to.
Was
Eos healing
me or something? It seemed like.
Falling in my skin.
As you can see in the background there, there's an opening, and it is now morning. We were in here all night.
God.
We're going to do the mechanics on this fight to show them, right?
Yeah.
Okay, that's good.
Let's kill these dudes over here.
Kill these ones over.
As best we can.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, I think it went after me because I put a bio on it.
Hmm. Oh, okay. I thought maybe it was going after Eos.
It could be Eos too.
Because I probably wasn't like, quite at full health.
Could also be Mantids.
Could be Nero.
Alright. Let's see.
There's some more dudes over here.
I gotta mute myself for a second.
Okay.
No. Take the women alive! We're all women.
To the abyss with you!
To the abyss with you.
Alright, before we step over that line, nobody step over it. Juba, are you ready?
Yep.
I'm pretty sure there are some lines here. Silly, you are to voice the bird and the boss, okay?
The boss, okay.
There you go, Juba, he's saying something over there. Can you see it?
Boss ain't gonna like this one bit.
You sully our spawning grounds in
person. That's fast.
Alright.
I died.
I thought he said something else.
Psh, finless fools. The lord of the world shall sup on your souls.
Alright. So I'll get the one to his right, our left, okay? At the front.
Okay.
I'll get, like, this one, and maybe the other one.
I'll get the one to the right of us right now.
Yep. So as you can see, there's things called unnatural ripples there. When they start to go, it'll say bubbles begin forming on the water's surface. Juba's gonna go and examine the them, and there's 4 points where they can happen. PMX just got the one in the back. Now, there's one here that I'm going to click to show you. And basically, the evil presence is gone, meaning we successfully did it. One's going to get out through the back eventually. It's just because there's not enough people unless the tank's doing it. But it's hard for the tank to do it because the boss interrupts you when you're interacting things.
You have to time it really well. You can just come up fast now, PMX.
Do you want a limit break or should I?
I'll do it. Time for the limit break. Check this out.
Oh, sorry about your health. I forgot you're so far out of range.
I was paying attention to where you were, so I knew that if you were gone for too long, I might have to do something. So that's part of working as a team.
Duty complete. Look at the team. We're all there. We all win. Especially Mira. Mira cheers. There you go. Okay. Acolyte's half gloves.
Mira will soon be a healer.
I win them. Alright. So we're gonna leave the duty? Yes. Okay. It's probably pirates. Objective fulfilled. Okay, so now I have to go back to Batteron at the Drowning Wench. So, I'm gonna teleport myself. Hang on one sec. I don't like that when I'm not in a dungeon, though. So let's say... Okay, now I can see everybody's names and such, but it's just their title and the initials. Alright, so I'm going to teleport myself to Limsa. Did I get the thing? Oh, I did get Aleport. It's good. We're going to go... Don't forget, Silly, you were voicing Batteron.
Okay. I tried to teleport too.
That's okay. So from here, oh yes, there's a good chance to show off Limsa Limensa. It's daytime. You can actually see out onto the harbor. So you see the boats there in the distance. Like, look how beautiful that looks. They did a really good job designing this city, and they didn't change it too much from 1.0 from what I remember seeing people play. I unfortunately did not get to play 1.0. Like, look at that. It's magnificent.
I know I heard the music was a lot better in 1.0.
For what, Limsa or the game overall?
Limsa.
Oh, because there's some points in the game where it definitely was better, like Thanalan had some better music. I don't recall Limsa's music, so it's possible.
There was a very famous music for the field outside of Aleport, I know that. And they took part of the theme from that and embedded it into the Aleport theme itself in this game, which is pretty cool. They varied it a little bit, but...
All right, here he is. Bateron, the Drowning Wench proprietor.
Okay. All
right.
Aye, such a task was on the books. Was, mind. I'm afraid the ship has already sailed, friend.
Ah, might you be the adventurer who accepted the job of investigating Sastasha? It would appear that the ship has not only sailed, but now returns to harbor. None the worse for its voyage, a pity. We dragged our boots too long on this one.
That's you, Payment. That's you, Pacament.
Oh, sorry, I didn't know there was a lady. No matter, the wheel will turn and our chance will come.
You are right, of course, but there shall be no rest till we have attained our goal, lofty though it may be.
That can be you, Juba.
Not a wink of sleep, great leader.
Our aim, lest you wonder, is to perform such feats of heroism as will earn us a place in the songs of every alehouse in Eorzea. We mean to write a legend which will inspire adventurers as yet unborn to follow our shining example. Do you have such a goal? Large or small, it matters not, only to have a star to reach for, and you will reach higher. Purpose can sustain you through times of hardship. Keep your eye on the prize, and all obstacles will be overcome in time. You would not think to stride into battle unclad, would you? Well, goals are as arms and armor for the spirit. I wish you fortune in your endeavors, m'lady.
Back then, are you? With all your limbs and the tale to tell, I'll wager. Fishbacks. And there I was, thinking you'd only have to crack a pirate skull or three. Seven hells. You turn your back for 5 bloody minutes and the scaly bastards set up shop on your bleeding doorstep. Still, sounds like you left them in pieces, so I don't suppose they'll be carrying out whatever mischief they was planning. Unless they was planning on feeding themselves to the fauna of Sastasha, of course. Any road, all's well that ends well. On behalf of Limsa, I thank you for shedding some light on this mystery. You've lived up to your reputation, and I couldn't ask for no more than that. Now, I'll bet you'd iron for a west, but just in case you're not, I was wondering if you might be interested in taking on another job. It just so happens that I've had a request from our sister guild in Gridania, see? Seems the forest folk are in need of a venturer who can get things done. For them to ask for help like this, you can bet the task won't be no skip to a sunny glade. But after the way you dealt with our fishback infestation, the chat went by too fast. Give us a shout when you're ready, and I'll lay it out for you.
All right, there we go. It's probably pirates complete. All right. Yeah, okay. Thanks, Juba. So there you go. Party Finder is unlocked. That just means that I will be able to do more quests. We're going to do this thing here now. Actually, before we do that, it's actually a good time to... The dodo is right there. Alright, so I'm going to...